Hello friends, I welcome you all to Nyandip Academy for UPSC and MPSC. Today we are going to study multiple choice questions based on the Hindu dated 14th December 2020. Let's begin with the first question. The first question is, which of the following is not true regarding the Kaziranga National Park? A. It lies partly in Golaghat district and partly in Nagaon district of Assam. B. Kaziranga National Park is a World Heritage Site and is famous for the great Indian one-horned rhinoceros. C. It has been declared as a national park in 1975. And D. The National Highway 35 passes through this park area. This is the Kaziranga National Park that is in news in the Hindu of 14 December. And other than new avenues of moving through this park, this national park have been opened up. In that context, it has been in news in today's newspaper. And of all these four statements, it is C which is not correct in this regard, because it has been declared as a national park in 1974. So it is C that is wrong. And the other three statements are correct in relation to the Kaziranga National Park. Apart from that, we should also know that it has been declared as a World Heritage Site since 1985. It is a home to 2/3 of the world's one-horned rhinoceroses. Elephant grass, marshland and tropical moist broadleaf forests are also found here in abundance. So that is some additional information about the Kaziranga National Park that is there in Assam. Moving on to the second question, which is about China's mission. Consider the following statements regarding Chang 5. 1. It is China's mission to Mars. 2. US and Soviet Union are the two countries that have retrieved lunar samples. Which of the above statements are correct? A. 1 only. B. 2 only. C. Both 1 and 2. Or D. Neither 1 nor 2. So in this context, if you have read about China's lunar mission Chang 5, it is a mission not to Mars, it is a mission to the moon. So in this context, the first statement is incorrect. But the second statement, US and Soviet Union are the two other countries that have retrieved lunar samples, and China is the third country that is in this process of retrieving lunar samples. The mission Chang 5 is expected to reach a place near Mongolia in the next week, and with that China's lunar samples will also get collected. So in this context, the answer will be only 2, that is B is correct. We also need to know some more things about China's lunar mission. It is an ongoing robotic mission of the Chinese Lunar Exploration Program. It was launched on 23rd December 2020 and it landed on the moon on 1st December 2020. It will also be China's first sample return mission. It is expected to return with lunar soil and rock samples to the Earth. China's lunar exploration is designed to be conducted in four phases. Chang 1 and Chang 2 are the first phases, whose objective was to reach the lunar orbit, which they did successfully. Next is Chang 3 and 4, which was about whose objective was landing and roving around the moon, which also they have achieved successfully. And Chang 5 is the third phase of China's lunar mission, and it is about collecting samples. And the next and the fourth phase is yet to come up, which is about development of robotic research station near moon's south pole. So that is about Chang 5 and China's lunar mission. Let's go to the next question. This is in context of the farm laws for which the farmers are agitating, and is found in the daily newspapers. Consider the following statements regarding Farmers Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilitation Act 2020. 1. It expands the scope of trade areas of farmers produce from select areas to any place of production, collection and aggregation. 2. It allows electronic trading and e-commerce of scheduled farmers' produce. 3. It prohibits state governments from levying any market fee, cess or levy on farmers, traders and electronic trading platforms for trade of farmers' produce conducted in an outside trade area. Which of the above statements are correct? So, if you are aware of all the three farm laws which have been enacted by the government, by the central government, and for which the farmers are agitating, demanding a repeal of all the three laws. And in this context, these are all the provisions of the first act. And the answer to this is D. All the three statements are correct. So all the three statements that I have given here is going to help you to write in detail about the first farm law, which is the promotion and facilitation related to the farmers' produce, trade and commerce. We also need to know some extra information. We also need to know some additional points that will help us to understand this act better. And that is, the objective of the government is to dismantle the existing trade and distribution monopoly that is enjoyed by the Food Corporation of India and the Agricultural Produce Market, that is APMC. The act also allows for the farmers to sell outside their designated district APMC, thereby advancing the interaction with the market directly. The government intends to deregulate the farming sector and offer farmers freedom of choice to sell their produce without restraint. So this is the objective of the act, and these are the provisions of the act which you would need to know. Let's move on to the next one, which is again about the farming, from the farming vocabulary, and it is in news. What is MSP, that is a minimum support price? A. It is the price at which products would directly be bought from the farmers if the open market prices are less than the cost incurred. B. It is the price at which the products would directly be bought from the farmers if the open market prices are more than the cost incurred. C. It is the price at which farmers sell their produce in the market. Or D. It is the minimum price at which private traders procure the produce from the farmers. Here the answer is A. It is the price at which products would directly be procured from the farmers by the government if the open market prices are less than the cost incurred. We will need to understand some points about minimum support price, which will help us to understand this concept better. It is the price which is set by the government to purchase crops from farmers, whatever be the market price of the crops. Minimum support price is declared by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs before the sowing time on the basis of the recommendations of the Commission for Agricultural Costs and Prices. Minimum support price is generally affects the farmers. So it affects the farmers in the sense they will the farmers take the decision on which crop they are supposed to sow depending upon the minimum support price that is announced by the government. So in this context, the answer is A, 4A. Let's move on to the next question. Which is the first Indian state to issue masala bonds? A, Karnataka. B, Tamil Nadu. C, Andhra Pradesh. Or D, Kerala. The first state to issue masala bonds is Kerala. So the first question that must have come to your mind is, what are masala bonds and what are they used for? Yes, we will see all that in this analysis section. So masala bonds are basically rupee denominated bonds. Their objective is to raise funds for infrastructure projects from the overseas market, but not in a foreign currency, but it will be in an Indian currency. They are debt instruments which are issued by an Indian entity in a foreign market to raise money in Indian currency instead of dollars or local denomination. Kerala became the first state to issue masala bonds worth rupees 2,150 crore on the London Stock Exchange. State-owned Kerala Infrastructure Investment Fund Board, that is KIFB, had issued bonds to raise funds in the overseas market. So that is about the masala bonds, and it is Kerala which was the first state to issue the masala bonds in an overseas market. So that is all for today's Hindu, and we'll see you in the next session with a new set of multiple choice questions based on 15 December's the Hindu. Thank you.